Tesla upgrades the Powerwall as it steadily builds a global virtual utility. In this report, I'm going to tell you why is this important, what this means for battery electric vehicles. This is Armen Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news and ring the bell so you don't miss my next Tesla coverage. Give us thumbs up, please. Charles Morris reports on Evannex that Tesla's energy storage and solar products fit into a highly ambitious vision of what the company sells, decentralized global electric utility. The potential is gigantic. Elon Musk has said that Tesla Energy, the company and company's energy generation and storage division, could someday outgrow its automotive business. And I agree, because one day there is going to be more need for energies for electric vehicles. The idea is that solar roofs generate renewable electricity and power walls provide storage and interface with the electric grid. The power wall and the solar roof are now a package deal. Tesla no longer sells one without the other. I have reported about that at Torque News. Check it out if you don't know the details. Now, the Tesla Energy Plan and Tesla Virtual Power. Plants are two more pieces of the puzzle. Tying the various hardware components into a system designed to provide low-cost renewable energy for consumers and dispatchable generation assets for utilities. Now, the company has taken another step, Morris reports, towards making this system a reality with a new software update for Powerwall. So what is that update? The latest Powerwall software version 21.13.2 adds a number of new features and deepens the device's integration with the Tesla Energy Plan and Virtual Power Plant. This is why in the beginning I said virtual. The Tesla Energy Plan is an energy tariff specifically designed for homes with solar and Powerwall instead, offering 100% clean electricity and savings of up to 75% compared to Big Six tariffs based on electricity consumption of 8,000 kilowatt hour years, says Tesla. Now, recently, Tesla also updated the Powerwall 2, now called Powerwall 2 Plus, giving it a higher power capacity. Meanwhile, the company says it now has 200,000 Powerwall installed around the world. Tesla installed as many Powerwalls over the last year as it did in the previous 5 years. Can you believe that? Also recently, Elon Musk confirmed that Tesla currently has a Powerwall backlog of 80,000 orders, which is worth over $500 million, but it can't ramp up production to meet that due to the global chip shortage. So what can be done here, friends? Tesla has been in a production constraint with the Powerwall for a long time. The demand has been strong, like I said a little bit ago, and it has been strong in several markets like the US and Australia, but production hasn't been able to catch up despite significant ramp ups. As we recently reported, it took Tesla about 5 years to deploy the first 100,000 Powerwalls, and then it deployed 100,000 more home battery packs over the last year alone. This is why I said Tesla last year did more than the previous 5 years alone. So the business is picking up. There is good opportunities here. It shows a massive ramp up in production and installation. But now, as CEO Elon Musk says, that Tesla still has a backlog of 80,000 Powerwall orders, Electrek reports. And the report says the CEO made the comment during his trial in Delaware a couple of days ago as he is being sued by some Tesla shareholders over the acquisition of SolarCity, which they see as Musk using Tesla to bail out another company that he controls. You probably were aware of the SolarCity lawsuit against Tesla, or I think it's against Elon Musk. I am not in the top topic. Musk finds himself to explain the logic behind combining the two businesses and the integration of Tesla Powerwall into SolarCity's residential solar offering is one of the best examples of synergy between the two companies. That is Musk's position on this issue, friends. Now, during his testimony, the CEO of Tesla reportedly revealed that Tesla currently has about 80,000 Powerwalls on order, but he believes that Tesla can produce only between 30,000 to 35,000 this quarter due to supply chain issues. This is what is reported also in CNBC. Tesla CEO Elon Musk revealed in court on Monday that demand for Tesla Powerwalls stands around 80,000 units. I'm quoting CNBC now, just to be correct. But the company's company won't be able to make even half of that many this quarter. In the best case, Musk said, Tesla will produce 30,000 to 35,000 of its home backup batteries in the current quarter. He blamed the expected shortfall on chip shortages. You know, chip shortage is plaguing the automotive industry and looks like many other industries like the Powerwall or electric utility industry. Now, to be fair, the deployment of 30,000 Powerwalls this quarter would still be quite significant, since we would be talking about over 400 megawatt hour of energy capacity, reports Electric, and says last quarter Tesla disclosed 445 megawatt hour of energy storage capacity deployed, but the number also includes power packs and mega packs, which are believed to account for most of the capacity. Recently, Elon Musk also announced that Tesla is stopping the deployment of Powerwall battery packs on their own. Like I said a little bit ago, it is instead Powerwalls will have to be deployed with solar power systems. Tesla also recently announced the Powerwall 2 Plus, which comes with a higher power output. The company has talked about ramping up production with the new version of the Powerwall. Now, there is an interesting comment on Electric about this development, and that comment is by a user named Gus Levi, who says, it's clear to most people who follow the topic, like readers of sites like Electric, that the general public is literally on the cusp of realizing that the S-curve adoption of battery electric vehicles is occurring as we are talking about this story right now. Many people out there will soon discover that their next car purchase will be a battery electric vehicle. They'll consider that BEVs, battery electric vehicles, perform better, are cleaner for the air around them, around their children, around their families and society, and have greater practicality with great range and intuitivity. Grasp that since all their friends and neighbors are also buying electric vehicles, that there will be much fewer gas stations and mechanic garages very soon. Similarly, how soon will the exact same pattern occur for homeowners with respect to solar power generation and battery storage? Many of us know that the end of the story will definitely end with society having most homeowners generating their own power and storing the energy. The only question is how soon will that day occur. By the way, in my neighborhood, several of my neighbors already have solar powers generating their homes and generating energy for their homes. And that comment says that 20 years ago, 99% of people would have said that a society with majority or with new battery electric vehicles was at least 50 to 100 years away. It's likely the same would apply for home and solar if a survey were taken today. As a contrarian investor, that person writes, he says he thinks he'll be a guy who says that the majority of the new homes with solar and battery storage installed will be less than 20 years away. Better technology usually wins out much faster than we can perceive. I think personally that maybe in several years, as the solar power energy gets better and the technology gets better, I personally will be wanting to have a solar panels on my roofs. Now there are pros and cons for that, and the society is not going to that direction fully yet. But like I said, I see more and more people in using solar powers. I'm in Armenia right now, spending my summer here, and I see again more and more people having solar solar panels on their roofs, as there's lots of sun in Armenia. By the way, if you haven't visited, please come visit us. Beautiful country. country, great food, and a very welcoming society. Well, friends, let me know what your thoughts are about Powerwall upgrade by Tesla, the upgrades, that features that I just talked about. This is Armen Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla electric utility, battery electric vehicle related news. And subscribe to our channel. Give us thumbs up, please, if you found this report helpful. And also share in social media. We would greatly appreciate, as you will help to speed up the transition to electric vehicles and solar panels. Have a great day. God bless you, everyone. And I'll see you soon in our next report.